Happy Friday the 13th, and welcome to our Homecoming 2023 Recap Edition of Thunderstruck. We were there to capture some of the memories of HOCO 23 and bring it back to you. Let's check it out. Can you give us a tour?
Yeah, sure. Johnny, open it up.
So inside the microwave, we have some notebooks, a calculator, some tape, a charger, some papers, a binder, some lead, all the school essentials that we need.
What did you bring today to school?
This is a Champagne Bob. It's the embodiment of Drake, because I love Drake. Shout out Drake.
A peanut M&M.
Lala Loopsy suitcase. Cute.
I brought my little horsey, my little buddy. His name's Toto, and we've been riding around all day.
Can you show me how you ride your horse?
You know, every dad and baseball coach's favorite friend, the home depot bucket.
Hey, Toto head, Toto. Whoa, Toto head, Toto head.
I'm here with Elmo 1 and Elmo 2. What inspired you guys' outfit today?
The unconditional love between two men that just absolutely love Elmo.
What is your inspiration for today?
My inspiration is Jordan Belfort. He's a very successful stockbroker, businessman, you know. Very successful, in my opinion.
Hi, I'm here with Ariel, and what are you going to be in the future?
I'm going to be a construction worker. I really like building.
Get back to work.
Sorry, sir.
I'm here with?
Trent.
And what is your future self?
Navy corpsman.
Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Pretty much you're in the Navy and you help out people on the ship, so if they get hurt, you're right there.
I'm going to be dead when I'm older, as you can see by the cool skeleton costume.
I'm here with Mr. Taylor, and did you always want to be a teacher?
Definitely not. I wanted to be a professional baseball player first, and that didn't work out. And then I wanted to be a professional musician, and that definitely didn't work out. And then real life set in, and I had to figure things out. So here I am.
Well, we're glad you're here.
I'm here with Kobe, and what do you want to be when you grow up?
At some point, I would like to be a mother and a wife at some point after I like get a job and go to college and stuff.
I'm here with Hannah, and what was this year's inspiration behind Homecoming?
So we went into it with a few different options and possibilities for what the theme could be, but ultimately we chose this one because we thought it was something that was fun, and it was different from what we've done in years past. And we were able to like make it fun and different while also like still adding the classic element of like having it be classy and like a little more elevated.
What's some decorations or ideas of decorations that we can expect to see there?
So right now, inside, we're working on a few of our centerpieces, and really, again, we're just trying to get like classier. So we have like the vases with the red roses, just kind of because our color theme is like red and white, just to go with the circus.
What are some of the things we can expect at Homecoming this year?
So you can expect Homecoming to be a little bit different. Sadly, we won't have our Ferris wheel this year, but you can expect it to be replaced with some different entertainment, like different carnival games and stuff. And then you could also expect all the usual stuff, like the photo booths, the 360 camera that we saw last year, and just a lot of fun, dancing, karaoke.
Thank you. I'm here with the Homecoming King and Queen, Viviana and Peter, and how does it feel to win Homecoming King and Queen?
Exciting, scary, nervous.
I'm in disbelief. This should have gone to Michael. He's a better man than me, but I'm glad that I won it. All right, thank you.
Were you guys anticipating this win?
No.
Not at all. No. Michael. Well, congratulations, guys.
And now to May for sports.
Thanks, Scarlett. Let's go to the field now to revisit the 48-0 Homecoming game victory over Rev.
Young men and women representing you on the field tonight. It's time to cheer on our gridiron warriors who represent your town. You Kuiper, it's game time! Hey, records on my demo. Did y'all boys not get the memo? I do not stay at the Intercontinental. And anything I got is not a rental. I own them all. Figure it out, it's simple. But stop me going up like a crescendo. But I do not wanna be friends though. So yeah, song. What's the move? Can I tell the truth? If I was doing this for you, then I have nothing left to prove. Nah, this for me though. I'm just trying to stay alive and take care of my people. They don't have no award for that. Trophies, trophies. And they don't have no award for that. Shit don't come with trophies. Ain't no envelopes to open. I just do it cause I'm supposed to.
And how did you guys step up on defense tonight?
I think we really stepped up in the run game. We were playing against a really good running back. He leads the point CBL in points. And I think, yeah, I really showed it on the scoreboard, our ability to stop the run game.
And I'm here with Matthew. And how did that touchdown feel?
It felt great. We talked about the play during halftime, ran it in the third quarter, and I was wide open for the touchdown, and the rest was history.
And Jace, how did those two touchdowns feel?
They felt good. There's a lot going through my mind, and I was praying to God that I caught it, and I did, and then just helped the offense out.
Great. Thank you. Go T-Birds.
Nice work, Thunderbird football. And we hope lots of you take the flight over to Redlands High School tonight to support our football team on the road against the Terriers. Back to you, Scarlett.
Thanks, May. That's all for Thunderstruck. Hope you had a great homecoming, but be careful today. It's Friday the 13th, and stay off those middle stairs and watch your step.
I'm here to demonstrate why you shouldn't go up the middle stairs.